Hi everyone, my name is Mark Moikes from Big Mount Studio, and we are on our third video in our series of customizing the navigation controller. In the first video, we went over colors. The second video, we went over custom fonts. And in this third video, we're going to learn how to customize this back button right here. Okay, so let's jump right into it. And if you haven't watched the first two videos, I encourage you to do that now and to come to the third video so it just makes more sense. Now let's talk about this back button here for a little bit. There's actually two parts to this back button. The first part, this chevron or this arrow, that is called the backIndicatorImage. And this second part, the text, is called the backBarButtonItem. It's a lot to remember. But just remember, they both start with back. And one is the indicator image, and one is the bar button item. So that's important to know. Now, we want to customize this, and I already have an image loaded that is like these little feet icon, but they point the other direction. So here's how I'm going to do it. First, I'm going to go to the storyboard. We can stop this here. Go to the storyboard, select the navigation bar, and I'm going to come over to these two properties here. It's what I'm interested in, this back and this back mask. And both of these are take images. If you drop down, you see all your images. And the one we're interested in is step back. And we're going to set our back mask to that as well. Step back. And if we run it, let's see what it looks like. Okay, look at that. Now, can you guess which item this replaced? It replaced that arrow. And that arrow is the back indicator image. How do we get rid of the back bar button item? How do we get rid of this fantastic journey? Well, let's take a look. We're going to go into the code, and I'm going to go into the view controller that is closest to the navigation controller. Okay, and we have to do this through code. So here, we're going to do it in the view did load. We have some code that's already here from the previous tutorial. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to extract this into its own method. All right, there we go. And I think I'll create another function that I'll set the custom back image. Now, if you remember what I said before, there are two parts to this back button. Let's just take a look at it here. So where the feet are right now, that is the back indicator image. And this part right here where it says fantastic journey is the back bar button item. So that's what we want to alter, is that back bar button item. And again, we're going to use the same property that we did last time, the navigation item. Okay, here it is right here, back bar button item. So here, just to let you know, we can't set it to nil and just kind of get rid of it altogether. Instead, if we set it to nil, it's just going to go with the default, which is fantastic journey. So it's just going to keep that text in there. So instead, what you have to do is you have to replace it. You have to supply it with a new one. And you see there's a couple of different ones here. We want the one with the title because we want to give it a blank string. We don't want the string to show up. And for the button item style, we just want plain. Now, when we tap it, we don't want anything to happen. We just want the default action to happen. So we're just going to set these to nil. The target in action. No special actions to happen. And let's run that and see how it looks. All right, perfect. That's exactly what we want right there. So right here, we have a back indicator image that is showing up with no back bar button item text. Okay. All right, this is great. But what if you wanted to set that back indicator image in code? Well, you can do that too. Just make sure we know it's working. Let's go back to our navigation bar and let's delete these two properties. And these are the two properties we're going to set in code now. And this time it's a little bit different the way we get to it. We're going to go through the navigation bar. And it's right here, back indicator image. There we go. And I'm just going to set the back indicator image to an image literal. And we need to do the same thing for the mask as well, the transition mask. Okay, let's see how that looks. Great, still see the feet there. Okay, good. Now, what's happening here? Why does chapter 1 show up here? Well, take a look at the items we're changing. Whenever you go through Navigation Controller, you're changing something that's going to affect all view controllers. See, the Navigation Controller is separate, right? But it's used to manage all of your views. But when you change Navigation Item, that is specific to the view controller that you're on. And it's unique to the view controller. So that's why in this view controller, we set it to no text. But since we're changing just the navigation item, which pertains just to the view controller, then it's not going to affect all your other view controllers. So get creative. Think of a way that you can set this so you can just easily reproduce this on all of your view controllers. You can do that a couple different ways that I can think of off the top of my head. You can create a custom view controller where this gets set automatically, or you can create an extension method where you can easily call this on the navigation item. So you can say something like navigation item dot set no text, and it just basically calls this code. And you have to call that on every view controller. All right, great guys. I hope you learned a little bit more about the navigation controller and the different parts of that back button and how you can customize them to create a more unique looking application that maybe sets your app apart from your competition or apart from the other apps on the App Store. You can really give your app its own unique look. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Feel free to share this video on any of your social media outlets. And also, if you'd like, you can provide a translation just for the title and the description in your native language. And that'll help other people who speak your language be able to find this video and learn from it as well. Hope you enjoyed this series. If you have any feedback, please leave a comment below. If you have any other tips regarding the navigation controller, please share it with all of us because we're all here to come together and to learn more about iOS programming and how to make our apps look better. Thanks, guys.